Tropical depression namang maintains its strength as it nears Catanduanes province. Let's get more details from PAGASA forecaster Rhea Torres. Rhea?
Thank you, Denise. As of 4 p.m. this afternoon, the center of the tropical depression Amang was estimated based on all available data at 250 kilometers east of Daet, Camarines Norte. It contains maximum sustained winds of 55 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness of up to 70 kilometers per hour, and is currently moving westward at the speed of 30 kilometers per hour. And due to the effect of this tropical depression Amang, we currently have a tropical cyclone wind signal number 1 raised over the provinces of Catanduanes, Sorsogon, Albay, Camarines Sur, Camarines Norte, Quezon including Polillo Island, Marinduque, Tikau Island, Burias Island, Rizal, Laguna, Aurora, Quirino, Nueva Ecija, Bulacan, Nueva Vizcaya rather, Nueva Ecija and Isabela. Meanwhile, for the provinces of Visayas, signal number 1 is also raised over the provinces of Northern Samar, Samar, and Eastern Samar. Therefore, for this afternoon until tonight, heavy rains may be expected over Bicol region and Northern Samar area. Meanwhile, from this afternoon until this Thursday evening, intense rains may be expected over the northern portion of Quezon as well as the eastern portion of Laguna. Meanwhile, heavy rains may be expected over Rizal and southern portion of Aurora and the rest of Laguna and Quezon. Meanwhile, for the state of our coastal waters, since due to the effect of tropical depression Amang, we currently have a gale warning raised over Catanduanes, the eastern coast of Albay, eastern coast of Sorsogon, the northern and eastern coasts of Northern Samar, and the eastern coast of Eastern Samar. Therefore, for our fisher folks and those with small sea crafts, we are currently advising them not to venture out into the sea while larger sea vessels are alerted against big waves. And that is the latest here from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
Thanks, Rhea.
Other news, Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says he has met with former Negros Oriental Governor Pride Henry Teves. Remulla said he spoke to Teves just before the Holy Week break. Teves is the brother of embattled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr., whom Remulla considers the main mastermind in the March 4 murder of Negros Oriental Governor Roel de Gamo. The Justice Chief says Pride Teves reiterated he's not involved in the assassination of his successor.
He did not in any way participate in any of these things that happened. We discussed some of the matters at length, but of course we tried to avoid matters that would in any way compromise our position or his position, because he was in the presence of counsel. Attorney Raymond Fortun was with him.
The Philippine Transportation Department says it is looking to complete several infrastructure projects before President Marcos's second State of the Nation address in July. These projects include 20 ports as well as 18 airport maintenance projects. The agency hopes to complete them by June. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista reveals road and rail projects are also among the agency's priority programs.
We have reported finalization of different contract packages for the North-South Commuter Railway, also contract packages that we signed for the Metro Manila Subway. No? And also we reported developments as far as the completion of some railway projects, like for example yung MRT7, no? Which we expect to be completed by June of 2025. No? Also the extension of LRT1, no? From Baclaran to Sukat, no? Which we expect to be completed by 2024. No? So these are more projects on aviation, maritime, road sector, and rails.